Hi guys, today I'm going to talk about the top 5 plausible methods of interstellar travel. The countdown will go from the slowest method to the fastest one. I would really appreciate if you could please subscribe and, most importantly, activate the notifications. Alright, so now let's start. The Partrun rocket would produce electromagnetic fields to collect hydrogen while traveling through space and then fuse its protons in order to create thrust. The scoops which collect the hydrogen would have grids made of lasers to ionize the hydrogen, I mean by removing its electron, and therefore facilitate the collection. With this method, the spacecraft could achieve around 10% the speed of light. There are several nuclear fusion projects, but one of them is Project Icarus, currently run by the non-profit organization Icarus Interstellar. They have proposed a rocket that would use lasers to compress isotopes of, ideally, deuterium and helium-3 to produce their fusion. Helium-3 would have to be extracted from the moon, for example. With this method, the spacecraft could also achieve around 10% the speed of light. In 2016, the billionaire Yuri Milner and Stephen Hawking announced a project called Startshot to send nanocrafts to Proxima B. These nanocrafts, which are miniature space probes attached to light sails, would be sent in 2036 and arrive in 2056. Around 1,000 nanocrafts would be launched to a high altitude orbit. They would deploy and a laser array based on Earth would accelerate them one by one. The objective is to send them within 150 million kilometers from Proxima B in order to photograph the exoplanet. With this method, the nanocrafts could achieve 20% the speed of light. Antimatter particles are identical to their counterparts but with reverse charge and spin. One of the projects is called the Vacuum to Antimatter rocket, designed by Icarus Interstellar. This rocket would receive energy from the destruction of, ideally, positrons and electrons of hydrogen when they attract each other and collide. The spacecraft would have to initially approach the Sun in order to charge a set of solar panels to power a series of lasers that would create electromagnetic fields to produce pairs of positrons and electrons directly from the vacuum of space itself. With this method, the spacecraft could achieve 40% the speed of light. The Nanofeed, which stands for Nanoparticle Field Extraction Thruster, is an experimental engine under development by the University of Michigan. The thruster creates electric fields that charge and accelerate carbon nanotubes, which are molecules of carbon. These particles are expelled out of the nanocraft, consequently pushing it in the opposite direction. With this method, the nanocrafts could achieve 90% the speed of light. Alright, and that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching. Feel free to leave any comment, suggestion or question below. Please like, subscribe, activate the notifications and share this video if you want. Bye bye.